the shark, babe, has such teeth, dear, and it shows them pearly white. Just a jackknife has old Maggie Heath, babe, and it keeps it out of sight. You know when that shark bites with his teeth, babe, scarlet billows start to spread. Fancy gloves, though, where's old Maggie Heath, babe? So there's never, never a trace of red. Now on the sidewalk, ooh, Sunday morning, lies a body just oozing life. And someone sneaking round the corner. Could that someone be Mac the Knife? There's a tugboat down by the river, don't you know, where a cement bag is just drooping on down. Oh, that cement is just, it's there for the weight, dear. Bible get you 10 old Maggie's back in town. Now you hear about Louis Miller, he disappeared, babe, after drawing out all his hard-earned cash. And now Maggie Heath spins just like a sailor. Could it be our boy's done something rash? Did he dive up? Yes, Sugi Tawdry. Ooh, Miss Lottie Lenya. And old Lucy Brown. Oh, the line forms on the right, babe. Now that Maggie back in town. I said Jenny Diver. Oh, Sugi Tawdry. Look out to Miss Lottie Lenya and old Lucy Brown. Yes, that line forms on the right, babe. Not that Maggie's back in town.
Greetings, everybody. It is a joyous day, an absolutely fantastic day. I'm still piecing everything together here, but it definitely seems like Tangerine Cat and Cyrax have broken up. The trolls have won again. The trolls will always win. I'm not entirely sure what has happened to this point. I saw that Cyrax was calling her a whole bunch of names and seemingly was siding a lot with Lava. And, you know, Lava's a known troll. We don't exactly have the same style of trolling. It's kind of like Jenny from the Block. Like, I don't particularly like her, but she is a troll. And I do believe that it is an art. And I know for a fact that Lava is a troll. It's just... the bottom line. And I mean, am I upset that I wasn't the one who was able to break up the two of them? Not really. I don't know how much of a knife or how much the knife factored into it. But all of our communal effort has led to a joyous day. I don't know if you guys have more information than I do. I really have not been paying too much attention to it. Let me check the chat here. I'm going to get right into it here. And unless I'm missing something here, this is all available information we have at this point. And naturally, it's our duty to dissect it. and get right into it here.
What up, y'all?
So it seems. I mean, for all we know, Jenny from the Block is Lava Girl.
How the fuck y'all doing tonight?
I was surprised to learn that Tange wasn't Jenny from the Block. I mean, I was dead certain that she was a heat.
How the hell y'all doing tonight, man?
Definitely, just completely floored me.
How is everybody tonight? What up?
Well,
Don't worry, man. We're still weeding people out. So don't worry, man. It'll get taken care of.
So I guess he's still going through his vetting process here. I almost think that this is an act. I mean, Cyrax has made a lot weirder publicity stunts than this. You know, the faking the Candle Smith thing. Falsely accusing me of murder. Like, he'll go saying that Ed overdosed. He'll go to any lengths to perpetuate his ruses here. So this might be an April Fool's come early. You never really know with this guy.
We're still waiting people out. Don't worry. But I got something I want to fucking speak on here. By the way, shout out to the big homie, Bloody Kiki, man. What's good, bro? I see you, dog.
Yeah, I see BK made a video on me. You know, I would take it personally, but I'm just such a huge fan of the guy. Always have been. He's made this video saying that he's leaving the community and he's donezo and whatnot. You know, I certainly hope that's not the case. He just does such tremendous work. For those of you who are unaware, I mean, I doubt that's too many people, but, you know, the guy's good at what he does.
I see you, big dog.
I do think it's cute that Cyrax is ignoring the terrible things that Bloody Kiki has said to him, though. But I understand. He's all in on anti-Marty.
But, Marty, you done fucked up.
How so, Cyrax?
You fucked up big time, man. You see, I saw that video that Boyd had posted. But let me tell you, I give props to Boyd for that shit, man. 100%. If you want to watch the video for yourself and what I'm about to speak on, click the link in the description. It'll take you to the video. But, Marty, you want to sit there and say if Jews were like jugglers, Hitler did nothing wrong? Bro.
I stand by that statement.
Oh, you are off your goddamn rocker, boy. See, Hitler did something wrong. Hitler killed thousands
of Jews, guys. Thousands of Jews.
Fucking people. The joke.
I mean, even when Cyrax is trying, you know, it still backfires. you know.
Jews ain't killed nobody. Yeah, there was a couple people that I killed in the name of being juggalos, but they were fake.
Wait a second.
And then you want to sit here and talk all this crap?
Hang on a second. I'm trying to follow here.
The name of being ain't killed nobody. the fucking people. Hitler killed thousands of fucking
people. Okay, we got that.
The Juggalos ain't killed nobody.
Well, the Juggalos definitely have killed people.
Yeah, there was a couple people that I killed in the name of being Juggalos, but they were fake.
Okay, so let's just evaluate this Juggalo logic here. No disrespect to any Juggalos here, but listen to this Juggalo logic. Yeah, some Juggalos got killed over faking being down with a clown. Like, so if you don't know all your Joker's cards in order, like, you know, it's perfectly legitimate to be killed. I mean, this is just astounding here. Oh, great opening statement. You know, I would love to delve into both these things, but I think there are some bigger fish to fry tonight.
And then you want to sit here and talk all this crap on me?
Oh, shit.
Like, I'm doing something wrong? And don't think I don't know about you.
Where's Tangerine? I don't see Tangerine.
Your fake-ass trolls. Don't think
Why do I not see that?
Including Tangerine Cat. Who, by the way, is fake. Okay, as
well, here,
fuck,
let me post that. Hang on.
Like, Tange, you ain't think I wasn't going to catch on to your fake fucking bitch ass? You're at your cat.
Yeah, it can definitely be pretty fascinating at times. Wow. Very interesting. Wow. Well, I mean, I have a feeling I'm getting trolled here, so I'm just going to proceed with this video until she appears, because, I mean, that's pretty solid.
Damn mine. You're out of your goddamn mind. See, I let you believe I was on your fucking side, but what you didn't realize, while you were trying to troll me, really, I was the one...
I mean, I wouldn't know as much as Cyrax or seemingly Lava Girl here, but I didn't see any outright signs of Tangerine trolling him or anyone.
Trolling you the whole time. The whole goddamn time. You ain't think I didn't pick up on shit? You're dumber than you fucking look, you dumb broad. You're dumber than you fucking look. Like, for real. You know the old saying? If it seems too good to be true, it usually is. That's you.
Wow. I mean, if this isn't the biggest case of self-sabotage I've ever seen in my life, then I don't know what is. Just baffling. You never look a gift horse in the mouth, Cyrax.
I mean, come on. We all know you ain't got 50,000 just stored away like that. And even if you did, here's my thing on that whole thing. Here's my take on that whole ordeal. If you had 50 grand, and your significant other, your boyfriend or girlfriend, was dealing with somebody that needed to have law enforcement involved and get a lawyer, wouldn't you be taking that money and putting it towards a lawyer?
Well, I would like to ask Cyrax this. How much money did he put towards the attorneys for getting Heather her kids back? You know, this just seems to be a cash grab. I mean, again, like, he has more interaction with Tangerine Cat than I do, a lot more. And I don't know. He definitely knows things that I don't. I just wish he could elaborate on them, because I didn't really hear much as far as proof goes.
instead of just sitting back doing all this dumb shit. Like, for real. What up, Katrina? How you doing, fam? No, like, for real.
You know, I wanted to be the guy that would break up Cyrax's relationship. I really did, but I'm just glad that the job got done, you know.
Like,
no way.
Yeah, I know that word.
Say something. Is this really the Tangerine Cat?
Hello. Yes.
Whoa. Okay, my first question is, what happened?
Well, it was certainly unexpected. I went into a call, a group call with Chance and Lava Girl today, and I went to confront her about actually telling Chance, I think, that, you know, she's a major troll, she's trying to destroy his channel, and one of the major things that she's been stringing him along with is a promise of a lawyer that would help in a civil litigation against yourself.
Well, fair. And first and foremost, I do want to apologize about the whole knife thing. Just, you know, but beyond that, you know, hopefully we can move past that. Yes, tell me more about that situation here. I don't understand, like, how that would lead to the dissolution of your relationship.
Right, okay then. Well, yeah, I mean, with the knife thing, fair enough, and thanks for the apology. It's just more important for me now to try and get through to Chance that he's being trolled hard. So a few weeks ago, I don't know if you remember, but he was overjoyed by the fact that he thought that he had you beat, and the reason was that Lava Girl had put you in contact, also she said, with a lawyer from Dayton who would take Chance's case on a pro bono, excuse me, pro bono.
Sorry, there was a clown dancing backstage. I don't know if you saw it or not. I was just completely distracted for
anyway,
he had a clown mask on and he was just bouncing up and down, and it completely threw me. If you could back up like 20 seconds, I'm sorry about that. ADD.
Yeah, so he agreed to take a case on a pro bono basis, and he apparently, this is allegedly, I've not seen any evidence of this, when I dug deeper and asked Chance about it, he said that Lava Girl had done all the talking, because he did make it sound like he'd been on this call, it was, you know, he's the one who's been talking to this lawyer. So then I found out that, you know, it was only Lava Girl that had spoken to him. And then it turned into, well, she's emailed him. So I kept asking him, I said, well, can we see evidence of this? And none ever came forth. It got to the point where Chance was calling the lawyer, you know, to find out what was going on and to find out when they could start, you know, meet, discuss the particulars of the case, introduce even a basic introduction. He didn't know really about any of the fees or anything.
So basically, you were just looking out for him, it seems.
I was looking, yeah, definitely. And it just seemed a little bit woolly. There wasn't any specifics. I didn't think that any lawyer would want to speak to a third party without knowing who they were, how they were connected to the case. And so I challenged this, and I let Chance try to contact this lawyer's office, and he did he did it every day last week, and no one ever got back to him, no one returned his call at all. So I knew then it was absolute BS. I contacted them to find out a little bit more about this, and I understand they're not going to start giving me names of people who contacted them or any details like that. But what I was able to find out is the lawyer that Chance had been told to contact, John's daughter, is actually an employment labour lawyer. That's his speciality.
Can you spell his name?
Yeah, it's John, J-O-H-N. S-A-U-T-E-R.
Okay, 1 second. Right here, 1 second. So I guess 70% of his practice is employment and labor, 10% admin law, and a very small fraction civil litigation, which, I mean, it seems like employment is what he specializes in.
Yeah, and the other thing is, this guy's been—he's a rising star within his sector. He's been put forward for awards by his peers, and it just doesn't sound like the kind of guy who would be representing someone for a very nominal amount of damages when there'd be no financial interest for his office. Do you know what I mean with that? So today I spoke to Lava a couple of days ago because she'd been in Chance's ear about being skeptical of me.
Also, because people have been asking us a lot, is Lava Jenny from the block?
I don't think so, no. She's a Canadian. I can tell she's Canadian with how she says about, because it's sure. Obviously for somebody from the UK that it's a little difficult to sometimes, to see a difference between an American and Canadian accent. Sorry about that. I know that could be so she's definitely... She wouldn't tell me. I mean, I told her my first name, and she wouldn't tell me hers or which city she was from. She just said that she was in the west coast of Canada. And when I asked Chance what her name was, he never seemed to quite know. So it was just all, she's obviously in his ear, and she's destroying his channel. She's managed to get various people banned who have been long-term supporters. Anyway, so to cut a long story short, I did speak to her, and initially I was probably being overly nice because I just wanted there to be peace. I wanted the relationship with Chance to work. I know people find it hard to believe, but I really did. And so I was very nice to her anyway today. Following the incident the other day, which I don't really want to
understandable. It's just absolutely fascinating to me because he seems so convinced, so resolute. What proof does he have that you've trolled him in any way?
I saw
this video and he didn't point to a single thing beyond Lava Girl says so. And if Lava Girl was just defensive, Dark Star Films. Oh, it's Cyrax.
Okay, one, I want to know, Tange, how the fuck am I being trolled? Like, seriously, come the fuck on. I mean, don't you find it kind of funny that when, first off, the reason why I haven't responded is because somebody fucking decided to hack my shit and kick me out of my damn account, so I'm not able to get back in whatsoever, first off. And second off, don't you find it kind of funny that when Lava asked you for certain information, you literally sat there and acted like a troll the whole fucking time? Like, what do you expect me to think? Like, do you really think that it's respectful for me to just hand over information like that without someone's permission? That's not okay. Like, but if you were to, hang on, like, if you were to send me an email, and you did not want me giving it out to anybody, I wouldn't sit there and do that. I would be respectful and be like, okay, that's not a problem. Like, I have no problem doing that. But what you did, that's like, for you to sit there and say, oh, he's going to send it to me anyway, like, what was I supposed to think or fucking do?
Then, and I'll tell you why, what happened there then. I went on the call, as you know, to, she was asking me for particulars of my police report for, and she doesn't know me.
Yeah, the reason why she was asking for that is so that she could help out. Because she wanted to add to the report so that she can help out.
I'll be someone from Canada going to help, but the reason why I asked for the emails and is because I was trying to prove to you that she's a troll. She cannot. She has no.
How is she a fucking troll? She's done nothing but fucking help.
Sorry, I should have shown you the emails.
Shut up, Marty. I've had enough of your bullshit, Marty. You've done enough damage as it is.
I'm just mute.
So I've been absolutely genuine with you, and I heard you saying that, oh well, you know, if I've got $50,000, why wouldn't I use it to put towards
why
a lawyer?
Wouldn't you?
Well,
that's the thing, why wouldn't you? Because if you got the money, if you got the fucking money to get a lawyer, why didn't you fucking do it right from jump? Anybody with half a fucking brain would have done that.
Excuse me, you couldn't even contact the guy. I've got more than $50,000. You know, I've got an inheritance, which is, you know, I don't really want to be talking on live stream, but you could have had the money.
Look, if this is for real, first off, we need to figure out a way to get my fucking Google account back because somebody fucking hacked my shit to where I can't even get into it.
Well,
do you know CIA
Hall would actually put, I've got a screenshot of him accusing Lava Girl of giving him the password. He's been accusing me. I've not given anyone any password. And he's saying that she's helped him.
I want my fucking shit back. Wait, Lava, I'm not out to attack you. But Lava, I swear to fucking God, if you did this, I want my shit back. And Tange, I want to apologize to you. I'm sorry for what I did, but dude, I want my shit back.
I don't have anything to do with that.
Where's my fucking info at, CIA? Hand it over. Hand over my info right now and I won't fucking call the goddamn cops on your ass, dude. Give me the fucking info back and I'll make you a mod on my channel or whatever the fuck you want. I don't care. But right now, I need my info back so I can help her out because this is bullshit.
It is because your channel is being destroyed in front of your very eyes. People are being like,
yeah, and I can't even do it. And that's the thing, I can't do anything about it. I'm not able to do a damn thing. Literally, I can't do anything. I've been sitting here for the last 2 fucking hours trying to gain access back into my shit, and I can't even do that. I'm literally locked out of everything. I can't access my phone. I can't access anything.
Can you not see how that's even more evidence that, you know, I heard you doing that stream. I'm absolutely mortified and devastated.
Tange, I am sorry about that. I really am. I really am. But hang on. I'll be right back. I need to talk to Mom because honestly, I'm going to talk to Mom and see if we can't get you down here soon so we can bring this out. Hold on. She's up. I'll be right back.
I think that's a good idea, yeah.
Hang on, I'll be right back. Mom.
This is awkward.
Yeah,
I can't. I'm not looking at the chat. I'm a bit embarrassed that I've had to wash dirty linen in public, but I'm so glad that I did, because obviously I've been able to maybe to resolve this.
Do you see this clown back here? He keeps coming back and dancing, and it's just very.
All right, Marty, listen.
All right, I'm done.
All right, listen, guys. I got a deal for you, Marty, and I'm pretty sure Tange will agree with this.
Okay.
If you can help me get my stuff back, I'll leave you alone.
Well, I don't even understand what's going on.
All right, so long story short, obviously you know about the whole situation with Lava Girl and Tange and me and her and shit.
Yeah.
Well, after we got off the phone, I went to go do something. I forget what I went to do. All of a sudden, I got locked out of my Gmail, my Facebook, everything. I have no access to any of it whatsoever. I can't even access my Google Voice that it's attached to. I'm literally locked out of everything. I've been sitting here for like the last 2 hours trying to break back in, and it's not doing any good. And I don't know
what the fuck. Do you remember when you changed your channel password about a week ago because CIA was trying to, it kept coming back into the chat? You gave myself, Lava, and Katrina Luna password.
Yeah, and I went to go change it today because I kind of figured something was going to go down. I went to go change it today, but apparently they fucking beat me to it.
Jesus.
And Marty, I do want to say, Marty, that I am sorry for that shit that went down between us, dude.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, you know, I want all this to end just like Lava does, you know. I want to be happy. She wants to be happy with me. Like, this needs to end, dude. And with my account being compromised, this isn't good. Forget about whatever I did in the past. Forget about that. Okay, right now, we have bigger things at stake here. I can't get back into any of my shit to try to help. Right now, I am of no use because I can't get back into my stuff, which leaves me helpless. I have no way to fucking help right now at all. Whatsoever. I'm literally screwed right now. Like, I can't get into my Google Voice. I can't get into my Google account at all. I can't get into anything.
Okay, I see Tyler's backstage here. What do you guys think about letting him on? If you're going to get upset, I don't want to do it, Cyrax. You know?
If he's willing to help me get my account back, then so be it.
Okay, all right. What, Tange, are you agreeable to that?
Yeah, absolutely. I just want to get this resolved.
Okay.
Hello, Marty.
Hey, good evening.
Hello, Cyrax.
Hi, Tyler.
You see that clown back there?
Huh?
Dude, like backstage.
That clown. No. Fuck.
Hang on, guys. Hang on. I do have to step away for a minute, guys. Come on.
All right. Oh. All right. Yeah, wait, who is he? I mean, I can't see him.
He has a named Jews Rock and.
Let's see him really quick. I want to go with this guy. I can't see him.
Can I just say that?
Yes, I know this guy. I know who he is.
I'm really relieved that
I know who he is.
The girl's being exposed.
Yeah. Lava Girl, he's accusing me from what it sounds like, and I don't know. For all I know, you both could be trolls. Tange could be a troll. You could be a troll. From what I'm understanding here, you claim that you were in discussion with an attorney. And here, let me pull his name up here. You claim that you've had some form of communication with him. That's what we're trying to understand here. I can post the link in the chat if you are curious.
Well, I'm surprised to say he hasn't blamed me for what happened. So he's locked out of his Google account. That's also like his main YouTube channel.
Well, so how is he? Okay, so how is he coming on here then? I don't understand
that. Okay, yeah. So his username is Dark Star Film. So that's how you can tell that he's using a separate
account. Sure.
Yeah. You know what? I do think he is locked out his main YouTube account. So close to 1,000 subscribers.
Hmm. Yeah. Huh. It is, isn't it? Very unfortunate.
This is a total mess, and you know, I've got my suspicions of how this has happened. I think
Tangerine, don't worry about it. We'll get straight to the bottom of this.
Yeah, I mean,
Cyrax is going to be a huge help in this situation. Don't worry about it.
Okay. I know Marty are a betting man. I would put a large amount of money on the fact that Lava Girl's the one who's done this to him. It seems to have all happened in the last 24 hours.
True.
She's up the ante somewhat. And, you know, I tried to warn him, but I'll send you a
screenshot. Yeah, he usually has to learn things the hard way.
Well, yeah.
I have no doubt about that.
Well, Lava Girl, listen, you know, if this is really you, come on and speak your piece. Like, do you have emails from this attorney? I would have to say that if you don't, then you are a troll. Like, why else would you lie to Cyrax about that? Cyrax was saying that, Tange, if you have $55,000, then you should be helping me with an attorney. Sure, but if you're lying to Cyrax and saying that you've already found one for civil litigation, then there is no legitimate reason for that. Come on, let's just put two and two together. And you know, the fact that you're not coming on here, it only proves to you and to everyone else, well, sorry, not to you, but to everyone else, that you are essentially a troll, it seems. Well, Lava, speak. I mean, what do you have to say for yourself? This is
Lava decides to speak up. I did get highly emotional on that call today, because I just, you know, trying to help the man that I love, and I just know that she's been so dirty with him, you know, making him feel secure, calling him a little brother and things like that. She's the worst type. A worse type of troll. She's just so, she's trying to destroy him, his channel, everything. And I'm...
Yeah, well, I'm glad that we can agree on something here. As much as I hate Cyrax, he doesn't deserve to be manipulated by somebody like Lava Girl.
No, well, not.
You know, I just don't understand why she's unwilling to come on here and speak the truth. Like, they haven't presented any proof of you being a troll. I don't know if it's...
She's no truth to speak. That's why she knows that, you know, she'll be totally exposed. It's not just a one-on-one conversation she's dealing with. You know, she's managed to get people banned from Chance's channel that have been long-time supporters. Motel Wi-Fi, I believe.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. Got your dumb ass in panel off, but she's got nothing to say. I mean... She knows that she can manipulate Cyrax, but she can't manipulate us.
Well, it has been confirmed that Lava Girl is actually a woman and not a guy. I haven't been keeping up.
Listen,
a woman.
And people may be wondering, you know, what's changed between Tange and I. I did get a call from the police, and it's just not something I really want to deal with. And, you know, I'd rather be on her side than Lava. I mean, they're virtually indiscernible. They're one and the same to me, but could backfire, and I just figured it would be best. But link me up. Yeah, Lava. All right, sure.
Okay, yeah, well, I'm not sure if I trust this, but, you know, Anthony can get Lava Girl up on the panel. I'm totally.
Yeah, for sure.
Open arms with that.
You know what, Lava? Here's what we want to see. We want to see any proof of correspondence with, what was it, John?
John Sauter.
Okay. That's what we're looking for. That's what we're looking for, or a valid reason why you would make that up. Those two things. You can provide one of those two things. If you can't, then you're a fucking troll. It's really just black and white.
Yeah, I mean, she was asking me for, you know, staff sergeant's name, what the case number was. She doesn't know me. She'd spoken to me once. And so today I went to ask her, well, if you want to help, give the details of this lawyer and let's, you know, let's talk. But she decided that, no, that'd be too invasive of her privacy. And you know, I had to call her out on it, and I think I did the right thing because now it's all out in the open.
Yeah,
everybody knows where they stand.
Sure.
And you know, to pick on, oh well, why would you know, why would anyone speak to you from the lawyer's office? Well, it was a case of researching what the situation was, not to get particulars. There were no particulars. No one had spoken to Chance.
Yeah, no, I can see Lava Girl backstage, but it says device is not connected. Yeah, and I'm not sure what that means.
Well, yeah.
Well, Tangerine, it's nice to
how convenient
not being interrupted every 5 seconds by Cyrax. The last time you two were up here, you were just trying to desperately calm him down and he wouldn't listen.
And now she's no longer backstage.
She's backstage.
Not anymore. She was. It said device would not connect.
Yeah, that's convenient.
Very convenient. I mean, I'll be honest. I do have a bit of an axe to grind with Lava because I wanted to be the troll who made this happen. But then she was. And we have very different tactics, you know. Extremely different tactics. At the end of the day, we're both trolls.
Well, let's not spoil things. You know, the olive branch has been extended, you know, a few minutes ago. I don't want you trying to ruin my relationship again.
Fair, very fair. I'm not sure. What do you think the odds are that Lava ends up duping him again?
Well, I'm wondering where he's disappeared now. It's making me nervous.
Hmm.
She was the one that sent him the ocarina, and I believe she sent him a poster or something today. I don't know whether she's trying to compete with me. I don't know, but it wasn't the case of having to compete. I could see that she was dangling him along, and he fell for it.
Okay, let me ask you this. Have you ever asked Cyrax for any, you know, I guess, distasteful news?
I know. No, in fact, I've always made a point of saying that, you know, I wanted to build the relationship in an organic kind of way. I didn't want to, you know, just be sending pictures and videos like that. I'm not about that. I'm a bit more traditional, so I asked him to refrain from doing that. I'm supposed
to be... So he sent them to you unwillingly?
No, I asked him not to. He did send a couple, to be fair, but I asked him, you know, for us to be able to get to know one another, and that would sort of thing come later. I'm actually meant to be going down to Akron to meet him on the 12th of March. This, you know,
yeah.
Lava Girl could have cost him, and it's a genuine, genuine offer. I got an inheritance. I want to help him. You know, I love the man. Mm. I love him.
Yeah.
I know people can't understand that because I know that he's got a temper and he might not be conventionally attractive, but I just do, and I want this to work.
I mean, he is, I guess, a bad boy of sorts.
Yeah. And I've dated guys before who have been on the...
Is he a real star face? I mean, I see Lava... I do think that was Lava Girl in the background because she did appear and it said that her device wasn't connected, and I think that's a weird thing here. I mean, I'm dubious that that's the real Cyrax.
That is totally something Cyrax would say.
And, you know, I've broken up enough of Cyrax's relationships at this point. You know, enough's enough.
Well, it was a long shot. I've had to come on here. I didn't want to. Of course, there's been, a lot of animosity between us. And it was just the only way I could think of to actually get him to listen. What else could I do?
I don't know.
I was in a panic, a blind panic.
So he said, okay, did you try getting a hold of him on Discord?
Yeah, he blocked me. So that was, he blocked me straight away because obviously she'd been in his ear before. Here we are.
Lava Girl.
Yeah, sorry about that. It's okay. Something to do with my browser. Sure. Can you guys hear me okay?
Yep. Okay, so who's this John or Souter guy?
Okay, so this is the thing. Like, I've actually been trying to help him. And I found this, like, this lawyer who, sure. I think he's from, like, Dayton. And I actually saw this webpage where he'd done this whole, like, cyberbullying.
I think I've seen the same page, actually. Right?
Okay. Yeah. And so I was like, okay, well, maybe this could help him. So all I did was email. Like, I didn't call them or anything. I just emailed. And I never heard back from anybody. And I just gave Chance the number and told him, you should call yourself and make an appointment. Huh. And, like, that's all it is. Like, I've never actually, like, talked to the people or...
So when Chan says that, that the lawyer was retained, was that are you saying he's lying?
He's been trying to get a hold of the guy, but he hasn't heard back from him. I haven't talked to anybody, like, personally. No, I've been trying to help him. Like, I'm serious. I've been trying to help him. Well, and I can't believe he just turned on me. Like, he just completely thinks that I...
What happens when you interfere? How does it feel? How do you think I felt being unceremoniously cast aside because you decided that you didn't like what I had to say?
Yeah, but it wasn't just that. It was a lot of things that led up to that.
So, what? I suppose, in the most way, what's it got to do with you?
I think he should be aware when he's probably just going to be led down this path. Like, we all know what's going on.
Well, from what it sounds like, if you told Chance that you were looking for an attorney, because I've heard him say that, Lava's hooked me up with an attorney. Shout out to you, homegirl. Whatever he says. But he said that, you're kind of guiding along this path and that he's been communicating with the attorney and you, and that you've been communicating with them and back to him. And, I mean, it doesn't seem to be the truth at this point.
Yeah, I haven't actually talked to anybody. Like, I tried to email them. And I gave him the number, and he told me he was trying to call, but he couldn't get a hold of anyone.
So, earlier on then when I said, well, yeah, this is how you can help by, you know, why didn't you just say that? Why were you?
The reason why is because I've seen so many comments of yours over the last few months in CGC's comment section, talking about him, calling him names, saying a bunch of stuff. And then just recently we had someone talking about some private Discord and coming out with some other.
Okay. I'll respond to that. One,
I'm on the phone.
If you're absolutely digging for comments from someone to try and prove that they're not genuine, it shows you up for actually being a troll, someone who's trying to get, you know, absolutely digging to him, ruin his channel. I explained.
Well, you know what, Tange? You know what? You can go for it. I wish you guys the best. I'm totally staying out of it. Like, I'm not talking to him anymore.
I think that would be best.
He just came on here and accused me of sharing his password or whatever. And like,
yeah,
like, I'm sorry, but
did he ever share his password with you?
Yeah, he did. But I told him, I was like, what is this for? Like, I think he gave me his YouTube password. And he said that if something ever happened or whatever, I could. And I was like, well, I'm not going to, like, that's just not the way I am. Like,
and then I'm not going to go in. Into his account? I mean, I don't know. I mean, you guys.
I have no idea what's going on there, to be honest. So, like, I have no, all I know is I, like, I'm just blown away how quickly he just, like, turned on me and just thinks, like, I've put a lot of time and effort into trying to help.
Can you see
him.
How I feel now then? Like how you two did that to me this evening.
Oh, I don't care what happens from this point on. I'm not helping. Either. I'm not
I was like Cyrax's number one troll, but this is pretty remarkable.
You think I am?
Make lawsuit things. So now
you got to provide
his password in you.
Well, sounds good. Okay, yeah, sounds good on here. I know what you're doing.
Okay.
If I was his biggest troll, don't you think you would know me?
Perhaps.
Yeah. Think we'd be talking? Don't you think we'd be talking in the private Discord, Marty?
Well, maybe I should send you an invite. If you want to post your thing in the private chat back here, I'd be more than happy to send it to you.
And why do you think I'm in this super secret sort of Discord? I don't understand.
Somebody told us. Somebody told us today. Somebody told him. And
did John R. Stouter call him up and tell him?
No. No.
Chance has seen for himself that there's a clone of my account.
I can't tell you who it is, but yeah, it goes into other Discords as Tangerine Cat. She wants all the credit for it. Yeah. Well, I mean, listen, I don't know. The Cyrax would every day say, you know, oh, the lawyer, talk to the lawyer is great, lava girl, and like. So he was just making all that stuff up?
I haven't actually heard him. I mean, I heard him saying stuff about, like, you know, us getting a hold of a lawyer and this and that. But, I mean, it wasn't – he's probably embellished quite a bit on that. That was. It's not like – I mean, yes, I've been trying to help him and letting him kind of – but I wanted him to do stuff on his own, you know what I mean? Like – I live in Canada. There's only so much I can do from here.
Have a relationship. So. Yeah. Well, I don't understand what you thought you would gain by banning everyone from his channel and, you know, being overzealous.
I'm not, but trust me, like, I'm just going to leave this alone. This is obviously something that I've realized, like, it's not going to end because he is perpetuating it. I told him not to.
His fault now.
I told him. I sent him. No, I'm not saying it's his fault. I'm saying he just. It's like I even sent him a message saying like, try not to respond to Marty tonight, no matter what like he says or what, you know, like so many people have done. Like, just don't respond. And then next thing I know, he's up here, like trying to, you know. And I'm just done trying. I mean,
the jig is up. Let's face it. I mean, a fake lawsuit. You know, you have his password and something he can't get in. I mean, I like that you're keeping up the facade, but I mean, 2 and 2 equals 4 here.
Yeah,
well, yeah. Questions. Accusing like a puppeteer, and the other one saying, "Well, if you guys really to do this,
you know, your troll game." I tell you.
All right. Well, Lava Girl, what do you find most attractive about Cyrax? Do you like his personality or do you like his looks? Like,
most attractive?
Yeah. What do you find attractive about Cyrax? Do you like his looks, his personality?
I felt bad for him. I just felt bad for him. I felt bad for him and just.
Oh, come on. Everyone that feels bad for Cyrax ends up dating him. It's a known fact.
I don't feel bad for him. I think he can be an asshole sometimes, but I tell him that.
Well, there you go. At least you admit it.
I've always been straight with him like that. There's a lot of things that irritate me about him, but that's like any.
Yeah, but I mean, I have too. But he wanted my help to like try to stop what was going on.
But did you really think it was going to work?
I knew it would just take a lot of time and effort as far as because he just trusts everybody so easily. And it's totally out of control.
You know what? I think Cyrax mainly listens to you. Because, you know, since he's just always horny all the time, you know, he sees that you're a woman and you have a woman's voice. So whenever a woman speaks to him and texts him on Discord and whatnot, he automatically tries to fight the urge to send you a dick pic and just.
Well, he hasn't sent me anything. I have a boyfriend and I told him that right from the start. So.
Has he ever sent you a nude picture?
Me?
Yeah.
No. I told him to stop doing that. Sending anybody any picture or video or.
Well, this might be unhealthy, but half of my gallery is just full of Cyraxes.
Hey, Tange, did you peg Cyrax?
Jesus.
Yeah.
<Okay. That's close.
laughs> Does Cyrax like anal rape?
Actually, yes. He one of his moves is the backdoor surprise. I've heard him say that. He likes to.
He's seen on his favorite anime, Dramatical Murders. It's a gay anime.
True. Thanks. Anyway, sorry about that. I may have been a mistake there.
I've got to say that, you know, once again, I categorically told him I wanted to. Go out about this relationship the right way, and not to send me any nudes because I know that he's been catfished before, and that's been the main to get to something to embarrass him with. And you know, we spoke about that's why, you know, I'm quite shocked. We spoke about this the other day, Lava, and you know, you agreed that we'd be civil, and well, he remained skeptical, which is fair enough. It's no skin off my nose whether he's skeptical about me or not. But and then to do this today, now he can, it's backfired, hasn't it?
I don't think it has. I think he's. I think he wants to be with you. I think you guys will be quite happy together.
I'm sure we will. It'll be as good a relationship as we make it. But I think YouTube's probably not the best place to cultivate a relationship, especially when there's people in his ear all the time.
Mm.
He's paranoid.
I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I won't get involved anymore. And I do apologize, Tan.
I mean, can you be Cyrax's friend and just be honest with him?
Who, me?
Yeah, although I guess it would kind of be a liability with the whole password.
No, I don't want to talk to him anymore. I don't want to have anything to do with him. I've tried, and I'm done. Like, I'm absolutely done.
Well,
he's accusing me of something I absolutely didn't do, and I've put so much time and effort into this, and just, I'm done. I've got, you know, I've got a life and a job, and, you know, I tried. What can you do? I'm sure I won't be the last one.
What does that mean?
Well, I'm sure other people will come along and, like, try to tell him not to respond or react or...
convince him that they've retained lawyers for civil litigation, you know, ask for his password.
I didn't convince him of anything. I told him exactly what I did. I found that lawyer. I emailed the lawyer. And that's it. And I gave him the number.
Why did you want the details of my police report?
Well, because I was pretty certain that if you didn't give it to me, that you were just trolling him.
So you think that not giving a complete stranger information that I found that unnecessary to give to someone that I don't know from Adam?
No, you could have just told me, no, I'm sorry, I don't feel comfortable doing that. And that would have been fine.
Well,
I haven't told him what to do. I've always told him, I've always said, you know what, like, I've been skeptical, but I think everybody should be like that. It's the internet. He said he's never video chatted you before. You guys have been dating for 2 months. I said, just be careful. That's all I've been telling him.
He's never even asked me to. He's just never, I don't know why, it's never never come up, I suppose, because I see him all the time. He's just never entered my head. So, you know, he's just out. It was so hurtful today, obviously, him just dropping me like that when I was willing to do such great things for him. And, you know.
Well, I'm sure now everything will be fine.
So I don't have to worry about John R. Sauter to this point.
John Sauter?
Yeah, the attorney supposedly contacted.
No, I just sent the guy an email and I gave Chance the phone number. I don't live there. I can't make him an appointment for him.
Well, I mean, did you send the email? Like, you don't remember the guy's name, you know? I just heard it a few minutes ago and I'm not contacting him for a lawsuit. But, all right, yeah. Sorry.
I mean, you have pretty much exposed yourself with this. It was probably a long shot that, I don't know, you've exposed yourself with this, though. I knew that it was totally fake.
Fuck you, Dick.
You know, Backbone, I agree. Yeah. I agree. We all need the email and password to Cyrax's YouTube account.
Yeah, so I mean,
oh my god.
You understand how that looks, right? Like, you have his password.
I don't care. I don't really care, to be honest. Do you guys care? You should be happy if his shit got hacked. Maybe not Tan.
You know what? I'm very happy.
I mean, the thing is,
why would you for going after me? Oh, really? Oh, is that what it's fake? Oh, yeah, okay.
You're fake. Well,
this is degenerated rapidly.
Well, I wish we would have gotten this shit ahead of time, because I would have definitely changed all his passwords and would taken over his YouTube channel and handed over to the Bloodshot Records team.
When you were screaming down at the line at me of how fake I was, you seemed to find it amusing. So I just, you know, I wanted to give you a taste of your own medicine.
You haven't done anything to me. My life is not affected by any of this.
Well, good for you. Good for you.
Yeah, it's pretty great to have this outlook, actually.
This has gotten very philosophical.
It's, you know, to try and destroy someone else's relationship, and then just it's Rich sat there saying, oh, it doesn't affect me in the slightest.
Oh, you'll be perfectly fine, I'm sure.
Are you going to want the ocarina back?
Nope.
You know, that's a great decision. I wouldn't want to take that back if he just put his mouth on it.
I know you guys are really enjoying it, too.
I am. That is the truth. I mean, that was a pretty solid troll, too. He does look pretty ridiculous when he's playing it.
That was not planned. I knew he liked Zelda, so I wanted to send him a present.
Brilliant. Troll of the year. Lava Girl. Front runner. 2021. Bravo.
Not a troll. Okay, well, anyways, didn't invite everyone here.
Lava, thank God you're here. Listen, we got a major. I don't know if you know what's going on, but
Why are you accusing me of giving out your password?
I'm not. These guys are.
Well, so Cyrax, tell me what happened.
Shut up, Marty. And Tan, you know you're in on it too, so I don't want to fucking hear it. And same with you, Tyler. I want my shit back, bitch.
Well, too bad, Cyrax. It's mine.
Oh, go fuck yourself, you little faggot ass too, bitch. But Lava, do you have any way that you can send me an email or some way that you can get a hold of me? Because right now, I have access to nothing. I can't access my other account where I have you on Discord. I can't access anything. These three assholes here literally locked me out of everything.
Too bad.
Hey, Tyler, why don't you
Jesus
fucking
Christ.
Choke my dick?
Why have you done that?
Hey, Marty, why don't you shut the fuck up and go choke on Tyler's dick, you little bitch ass nigga?
Fine.
I've had enough of your fake mouth. And
10 years ago,
listen.
You were like, oh, listen, sorry,
no, Tange,
I'm sorry.
You need to fucking stop and listen, Tange. You and Lava, I can tell you're both good people. But what I want to know is why are you listening to this fuckbag Marty? You both have good ideas. You both need to come together and make one good idea to stop this fat.
Do you mean why am I listening to him?
How about I don't listen to him? You're a fucking liar and you're a piece of fucking shit and you know it. You're a fake ass troll.
Oh, I'm out of here. I'm sorry, Chance. I tried to help you, but you accuse me. You accuse me of shit. And.
Lava,
whatever.
Listen.
I heard you want to be back with Tange, so
hang on, Lava, stop for a minute.
Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Lava, stop for a fucking second. Thanks a lot, you fucking bitch. I hope that both of you rot in fucking hell.
What?
Oh my god. Sorry, I'm a bit shocked. I thought.
I mean, either she can show the emails or she's a liar. That's how I view it. But I'm trying to understand what just happened here.
Yeah, me too. I really don't know. But yeah, I mean, I think it's pretty clear. You know, she was cool, calm, collected about it all. There's no emotional attachment. She was willing just to say, well, I'll walk away from it. Well, and I'm trying to fight for our relationship.
Yeah.
And well, embarrass myself once again.
You know, too bad for Cyrax. You know, he got locked out of his count, you know, so T2 wouldn't strike him down for us. But
did they?
I find it amazing. He's never going to hit that 1,000 subscribers, and he's not going to...
Is that the case? Is that the case? No, his channel's still up there, right? I mean...
Well, yeah, it's still up, but he lost his password to his email, and I don't think he'll be able to get back in because he's not smart enough to handle technology like that. You know, and that's just karma for him. Well, too bad, Cyrax. Seems like to me you won't be able to show your dick to any more innocent women.
Jesus.
For as long as you don't have your account back. You know, rest in peace.
This is another thing I've been receiving screenshots from an account I didn't recognize, and screenshots of Chance's body. And I believe that Lara has something to do with that because she let something slip on our first conversation about someone who apparently sent screenshots to her. I'm ignoring this because I know that obviously people do make things up about him, and she's, you know, kind of poison his mind.
Yeah, I mean, that's the thing that I've always loved about him. He's very susceptible to manipulation. But, you know, well, it's part of it.
That's why I've always told him that I won't, you know, ask Pat him. If I think he's doing something ridiculous, I'll tell him.
Yeah.
I'm just really upset at the moment. Obviously, I'm shocked, and I don't want to embarrass myself any further, really.
It's understandable. Yeah, I didn't even understand what he was trying to say. He was all over the place.
Yeah, exactly. And I don't know what's going to happen next, but... you know.
Yeah, we're just gonna have the next Tangerine. He's gonna create a new channel, calling out Marty, wishing death upon the BSR team, calling his best friend Bratley. Oh, it was us.
Sorry.
All right. First off, Marty and Tyler, I hope you're fucking happy. Because of you two, I lost a friend. And Tange, I'm sorry about what I said to you. But this shit has got to fucking stop. I don't even know why you're up here with these fucking idiots.
Because I was supposed to get a message to you. You blocked me. Why did I don't do things like
that? That's the thing.
Like,
I didn't block you. That's the thing. Right after me and you got done, I got fucking kicked off my shit by little bitch-ass Tyler and Marty. Thanks a lot, you two. And this ain't no fucking joke.
Sorry, she was lying to you.
No, shut up, Marty. All that ever comes out of your mouth is fucking lies, you fat fuck.
He's never talked to John Salter.
Actually, yes, I have. I've actually tried calling him. And guess what? I can't get through. You want to know why?
I know.
The team's always fucking busy. It is a legit office, but they are very
it
hard
is,
to get
yes.
through.
It is, yes. It is legit office, you're right. And you try and get through.
Marty, what I need you to do right now, I need you to help me get my fucking shit back. And Tyler, you need to quit with your fucking smart-ass mouth.
Why?
You need to quit with your smart fucking mouth, dude. I've had about enough of your shit. No, I've had about enough of you two coming in and fucking shit up for me. Enough is enough. No, you need to shut the fuck up and quit, Tyler.
What?
Me and Tanch have had enough of both you fucking assholes doing this shit. Shut the fuck up, you little bitch ass.
Okay.
You think it's a fucking game, dude? It ain't a fucking game, man. This is bullshit. Because of you two fucking morons, I now cannot get a hold of people that I need to get a hold of. People that are legit fucking family. I cannot access anything because of you two fucking morons.
Well, Cyrax, I really do feel bad. I'm sorry for what happened.
You really think this is a fucking game, Tyler? Like, do you really feel bad? Do you really feel bad, or are you just fucking joking around?
Sorry, I mean, I really do. Wait, hold on, I'm sorry to interrupt you. Cyrax, you know what? I'm sorry for getting your credit card information and all that. You know, I know that really pissed you off, but Cyrax, if you want me to apologize.
No, you listen to me, Tyler. Yeah. You're gonna fucking listen to me for a minute, because I've had about enough of your fucking bullshit, dude.
Sorry.
You caused me way too much fucking trouble as it is. Do you really think that I deserved any of this? Do you really think that Tange deserved any of this? No. You motherfucking dude, you guys sat there and sent a fucking goddamn knife to her fucking doorstep. Do you really think that's something to joke about?
You said you were raped, Mrs. Schmeckle. No.
It doesn't fucking matter, dude.
All right, fine.
No, listen. Y'all told me straight the fuck up that if I dissed Schmeckelcat, he'd back off. I did. Guess what? He didn't fucking do it. Instead, how does he fucking respond? Sending a fucking knife to my girlfriend's house? Are you kidding me? No, that's
I get old to be now. Can you access your emails?
What I'll do is I'll send you an email that you can send to.
Okay, so Cyrax, you know what?
Please.
I will give you a password. I do feel bad about it, but just let me try to speak my piece for a minute, all right? Because I think this is the only shot that you'll get at getting your password back. Will you let me do that, Cyrax?
Fine, speak your fucking piece, but it better not be no bullshit either.
Oh, no, I mean, this isn't bullshit. I just want to speak on this. Cyrax, I hope you understand why I did what I did.
Why did you do what you did?
All right. Well, because all the death threats you were sending out to me, Marty, Schmeckelcat, and I just didn't really appreciate it.
Tyler, what you need to understand is those death threats were brought on by you guys. You guys literally sat there and attacked me for years and years and years when I've done nothing to you. I tried running my own business. I tried doing my own thing. You can't ask Tange, dude. I have done nothing to any of you. So what in God's green earth makes you fucking think for a goddamn second that I deserve any of this? The reason why I came at you guys with those death threats, you guys brought them on. You sent a fucking knife to my girlfriend's house, for God's sakes. You really think that I'm not going to come back with something way worse? Like, bro, that's nothing to joke about, dude. That's not fucking funny, and it's not cool.
The reason why I came at you like I did
is because of what you guys did.
Well, Cyrax,
don't well me, dude. You and I both know that you two were in the wrong for this.
You don't understand what I'm going to say here to you. I mean, I really do feel bad. Like, this isn't really even a troll, to be honest. If you want me to apologize right now, I will, and I will give you back your password, because I do want to see you do your live streams again. So will you just allow me to just apologize for, like, 10 seconds at least? That's all I need.
Fine.
Cyrax, I'm sorry that you're an inbred piece of shit.
Jesus Christ.
Wow, Tyler, you're a real fucking piece of shit, you little bitch. You're a real fucking piece of shit.
I gotta agree with him here, Tyler. It wasn't very...
Like, dude, this isn't fucking funny, dude. And see, Jesus. Tyler, this is what I've been trying to get through to you, Tyler. The shit you're doing now, that's gonna get you fucked up by someone in the long run.
I know.
No, that fucking attitude, you say you know, but you don't really know, dude. That fucking attitude that you have right now, that's going to land you two places, man. Either in the morgue or in a fucking prison cell.
You don't think I know how you're...
If you think I'm joking, Tyler, try me. Because, dude, I used to have that same attitude that you had.
Hell, you still have the attitude.
That's the thing, Tyler. I don't have the attitude that you have.
Why?
I don't have that kind of fucking attitude because I'm not an immature little brat like you.
I'm sorry. I mean, I don't pull out rifles and threaten to kill.
Dude, he sent a Ms. fucking knife to my girlfriend's house, you fucking moron. What'd you expect?
How do you know that the knife actually meant harm?
Tyler.
To be fair, Tyler just sent Schmeckelcat the address. He didn't put the knife there, but he knew what he was going to do with it. So I guess we're all partially responsible.
Like, do you guys really think that this shit's funny?
No.
Dude, this is a fucking joke.
Yeah.
Because like, no, it's not, though, Tyler. It's not a fucking joke, man. It's not a joke.
It's affecting real life.
This is real life, Tyler. This is real fucking life. You need to get your goddamn head out of your ass and get back to fucking reality, dude. You need to get the fuck back to reality and realize that when you did what you did, you not only put my life at risk, you not only put my family's life at risk, you put my girlfriend and her family's life at risk. You think that's a joke? It's not, dude. That's fucked up. And let me tell you, Tyler, I would never do that to you or to Marty.
Well, that's not right.
You waved your gun around, Cyrax.
The only reason why I did what I did, Marty, and I'll be straight up honest with you, man, because you know I keep it 100 with you every fucking time. Yeah. The only reason I did what I did was because you pushed me to the point. Like, dude, you sent fucking rope to my house, told me to kill myself on a live stream, then had Tyler get my fucking banking info, and then you sent me another thing, rope, which was insinuating for you to want me to kill myself again. That's not fucking funny, dude. That's really not. All I've ever wanted to do, all I've ever wanted to do was to be happy with Tange and live our lives in fucking peace without the bullshit. I don't deserve this. She doesn't deserve this. Neither of our fucking families deserve this. You two fucking morons.
Do you think this girl deserves to be brought in?
You're a hard ass, Tyler. You're a little fucking kid compared to me, dude. I've been around the block, bro. I've been around the block, Tyler. And let me tell you right now, kid, that fucking attitude you got now, that shit's going to land you in fucking jail or in a fucking morgue. And believe me, I know firsthand. Because of motherfuckers like you and Marty, I've had friends die to suicide because of little bitch-ass niggas like you taking their hot shit going around fucking bullying people. You think that's a joke? It's not. This is real life, Tyler. You need to grow the fuck up and realize that, kid. Because if you don't...
Cyrax, in real life, you have to be a working class citizen. And
I guarantee you, Tyler, you keep this shit up. I promise you, you will end up Bubba's bitch. And it ain't going to be by not him or anybody else's. It's going to be you getting yourself in trouble.
And Cyrax, just in case anyone asked, you're never going to get your YouTube information back because you just threatened me.
And, fucking threaten you, dude? I'm telling you real fucking life facts, bro. That's not a threat.
Considering that you've admitted to a crime, I wouldn't be too cocky if I were you. You've both admitted to a crime that I've reported to the police. Yeah.
Like, okay, Cyrus, enlighten me. Tell me what's going to happen to me in prison, and maybe that'll change my mind and my perception of the current state of
the world I am in. Bro. Tyler, let me tell you something, man. Back in 2012, when I was a young kid, I had that same attitude you have now. I thought I was untouchable. I thought I was a badass. I thought I was everything in the fucking world. I thought that nobody could tell me nothing. I was like that, dude. I had that same attitude you have. I was going after people like that, dude. I was doing the shit you were doing, man. This ain't no joke. I was doing the shit you were doing, man. And you know where that fucking ended me up, dude? It ended me up behind bars. It ended me up in jail for 24 fucking hours. And let me tell you, dude, when they say time stops in prison, it really does stop. That shit will fuck with your head. That's not a joke. And let me tell you right now, Tyler, you will not last 5 fucking minutes in there. I barely lasted 24 hours. Okay, and let me tell you, dude.
Wait on how dangerous it. How dangerous is it?
And trust me, Tyler. Trust me. You think that you're this badass, untouchable kid, but you're not. You're not invincible. You're human. You're a human fucking being, dude. You're not untouchable, man. You think that you're this hard ass kid, but really, you're just a fucking dumbass kid playing gangster hard ass on the internet.
I'm a fucking gangster, nigga. You know how it is, Cyrax.
That's the thing, bro. You ain't no fucking gangster, homie. I've had friends die because of gangsters. Dude, my best friend.
Let me tell you something, G.
Nah, man. You ain't about that life, dude. That's the thing. You're not about that life. My best what? Friend Zach. No, my best friend Zach died because of a fucking gangster in his own family's fucking.
Which was you?
You think that's a fucking joke, bro? You think that's a joke? How would it, dude? Let me tell you this, bro. How do you think you're gonna feel when a motherfucker walks up to you and puts a goddamn barrel to your goddamn skull and pulls the trigger?
I'll tell you how I feel, Cyrax. I'm gonna laugh in the goddamn face.
You run your mouth, though, Tyler. That's the thing, bro. You run your mouth too goddamn much. You think everything's a game, but nothing is a game, especially when it comes to real life, bro. The reason I pulled that rifle is because y'all pulled me to that point. I didn't want to get pushed to that point. I don't like being that person. You can ask Nance. She knows me better than y'all two motherfuckers do. And she's only known me for 2 years. And she knows me better than you guys do. She knows I'm not an evil person. She knows I don't like doing that shit. I hate that shit. But when y'all fucking come up doing that shit, what do you expect to happen, man?
I expect to slap my face and laugh like you don't give a fuck, like you said, Cyrax. Doesn't seem to be the case.
But that's the thing, though, Tyler. You think I don't, like, dude, even though you're a royal fucking asshole, dude, I will give you that. You are a piece of fucking shit asshole. You're a little fucking kid that thinks he knows everything. But really, you don't know everything, bro.
Wait, I don't?
Dude, you don't know everything, bro. You really don't. Damn. You think you do. You think you do. But really, do you? Do you really think you know everything? Because let me tell you, bro. Let me tell you right the fuck now. The attitude you got now and the way you are right now, I guarantee you, man, you're going to end up in one of two places, either jail or in the goddamn morgue from you running your goddamn mouth to the wrong person.
And when how should I change my attitude?
Shut up, Tyler.
Let me
give you a fucking lesson here, kid. You run your mouth to the wrong person. Do you really think they're going to think twice about putting a goddamn cat in your ass and pulling the goddamn trigger? No, they ain't going to give a fuck. They're going to put your ass on the ground and they're going to walk the fuck away. You think you're a hard ass kid, but you're not.
Well, thank
you. Not the hard ass you think you are, bro. You need to realize that and you need to grow up. You need to quit this shit. You think all this shit is funny, bro? It's not. Because let me tell you, bro, since the pandemic started, bro.
70%.
No, listen, bro.
70%.
Why should I fucking listen to this little fucking kid when he takes everything as a fucking joke, dude?
No, Cyrax, I'm listening. Please. I'm really listening to you right now.
Because let me tell you
I've not had an email.
Tangerine, I'm listening to his life lesson. Be quiet for a minute. Let me listen to his life lesson.
Tyler, knock it off and show some respect, dude.
Yeah, I've not done anything to you. I'm just asking him for
Check the private chat. I sent you the email.
Yeah, well, I'm like really invested into this conversation. And I can't.
Sorry, I just want to make sure I don't lose contact with him. After all, I'll shut up now. Sorry,
Tyler. Why is it that you think you're such a badass? Like, why is it that you act the way that you do? Is it because you're trying to prove something? Because if you got something to prove, what is it that you're trying to prove? I don't get it. Like, why have the attitude? Like, here's my thing about it all, bro. You can do one of two things. You can either take that attitude and put it towards good shit, like what I'm trying to do, what Tange is trying to do, and trying to help people. Or you can continue on this path that you're going, and you could end up in serious trouble, dude. You think that this shit ain't gonna catch up with you, man? You really think this shit ain't gonna catch up with you? Trust me, dude. I know firsthand. Okay, you're talking to somebody who is older than you, wiser than you, who has actually been around the fucking block, who has gone through shit, who has been where you're at, who has had the attitude that you've had. I used to be that kid, Tyler. I used to be that kid that thought he knew everything, that thought he was a badass. But let me tell you, bro, I got put in my place real fucking quick. And I learned real quick that I learned real quick that I wasn't the badass that I thought I was.
By who?
And guess what? I humbled up and I smartened up. And I'm telling you right now, Tyler, if you don't change your ways now, if you don't change your ways now and quit this shit, you're going to end up hurt in jail or
dead. Why do you care about my well-being?
How do you think your family's going to feel? How do you think your family's going to feel when they find out that you are dead? How do you think they're going to feel, bro? They ain't going to like that too well.
Well, sorry, I couldn't say the same for your family.
You need to change your fucking ways, dude. You're talking to somebody who has experience, man.
With what?
With being a fucking hard ass. Because that's the way you act. You act like you're a hard ass. But really, all you do is sit up on the internet acting like a goddamn keyboard warrior, bro. It ain't funny and it's not cool. It's stupid.
Cyrus, can I ask you a quick question about, like, you know, like, how did somebody change your perception of reality? Like, who did that?
That's easy, dude. It's called being a good person. It's called stop being a fucking smartass and acting like you know everything. When really, you don't know shit.
Well, Cyrus, if you're so smart and so positive, why do you threaten to slit my throat and put a bullet between my eyes?
You want to know why? Because you and Marty pushed you to that fucking point, dude. You and Marty pushed me to that point of doing that. And do you think I like being that person? No, I hate being that person. I hate
it. Why do you act like that person 24 hours a day?
I don't act like that person 24 hours a day. You can ask Tange, dude. Outside of YouTube, outside of y'all two motherfuckers, I'm chill as hell.
Yeah, yeah. It calms me down. I'm the one with the temper.
Oh.
Like, for real, dude, I'm not the bad, hyped up guy that you guys are making me out to be. I'm really not. And this is what I've been trying to get through to you guys this entire fucking time. If y'all would just back off and leave me alone and quit with the fucking jokes and the pranks and shit and let me do what I need to do, I wouldn't have to be that bad guy that you guys are making me be. I wouldn't have to be that evil person that I don't want to be. You think I like being angry all the time? I don't, dude.
I do.
I hate being angry all the time. I hate it. I don't like it. I don't want it.
I think it's like
you're not about that, though, Marty. That's the thing, Marty. That's what you want. That's what you want. You want to see me angry all the time. You want to see me pissed off all the time. You want to see me mad for your own content. And that's bullshit, dude.
Yeah, he's been
mad. Speaking on you, Marty, why is it that you think that I'm your personal content when technically, if you want to get real technical here, technically, I own your channel because all your content has my face on it, my videos. Therefore, your channel technically belongs to me because you have uploaded my shit without my permission. Technically, your channel belongs to me.
Your understanding of the law is not in nowhere.
Yeah, thanks for the subs, Marty. Thanks for the fucking subs.
You're welcome.
But your subs are gone, though. You got locked out of your account, and I'm sorry that happened.
Yeah, you want to know why? Because of your little fucking punk ass, Tyler.
Well, sorry, do
you really think this is a joke, man? Like, no. What I understand, what makes you guys think that this is remotely funny? what's so funny about sending a knife to someone's house and basically threatening their life?
Well, you threatened to rape so funny about that? You threatened
that's
to rape
not funny.
You threatened
that's
to rape
beyond fucked up.
Well, like,
Marty, I'll tell you right now, Marty, and Marty and Tyler, this is for the both of you, too. Okay. I would never do that shit that y'all did to Tange. And if if y'all both ask me, y'all fucking owe her a goddamn apology for what y'all fucking did.
I did apologize.
Yeah, we already did, Cyrax. We did.
This is what I find funny. This is what I find funny, man. Y'all apologize for going after my girlfriend, but y'all won't apologize to me for the shit you've done.
But why do you think that's funny, Cyrax?
Funny, dude. That's real fucking funny, bro.
Well,
that's
really why that's funny. She hasn't done anything. There's two reasons. One, she hasn't done anything to me. And two,
but Marty, let me ask you this, Marty.
Can I just say the second thing?
Marty, you want to know why I do this shit to you? That I do, it's because you fucking pushed me to that point by doing all this shit, by making these attack videos, you put me on a fake fucking predator list.
That was not me.
Bullshit.
Not
which
me.
Is bullshit, and you know it.
Not me.
You know
sorry,
it's bullshit. No, Marty, stop trying to fucking defend yourself. I'm being 100% honest with you. Why don't you be 100% honest with me?
Cyrax, I didn't put you on the site.
Then who did?
How would I know?
Yeah, Marty, you know damn well you know. Last night you were sitting there fucking laughing about it. I saw your live stream, dude. Don't fucking lie to me.
I think it's funny.
Marty, you know damn well that shit ain't funny, and you and I both know that I know you better than any motherfucker up in here.
Wait, hold on. How come you can tell us what's funny and what's not?
Hmm. But you gotta put yourself in my position, Tyler. You gotta look at shit from my perspective instead of your perspective. You gotta be willing to put yourself in the other person's shoes.
And Cyrus, maybe, your own ain't shoes, though. How am I gonna put myself in your shoes?
You really think this is funny, Tyler? It's not. How would you, Marty, put yourself in my position, Tyler. Put yourself in my position for a second. Imagine if I was you and Marty and going after you and your girlfriend and your family and doing the shit you did. You know damn well you wouldn't fucking Marty, shut the fuck up.
It's just a picture of your penis on it. I've never seen a sex offender registry where they show.
It doesn't fucking matter, dude. It doesn't matter.
It kind of does.
No, it doesn't, dude. That don't matter, bro.
It seems
like what you don't realize, Marty, is that if someone, like, let's say I were to actually go out and get a regular 9-to-5 job, right? What if somebody were to see that? I wouldn't be able to get a job because y'all two knuckleheads doing this shit. Because they're going to take that at face value. They're not going to look into it.
But they're going to know what your dick looks like.
Guess what? And guess what? No fucking job.
Have you ever been to Alabama? Yeah.
You think this is fucking funny, dude. It's not a game, bro. No, I'm not talking about you, Marty. I'm talking about this little fucking asshole, Tyler.
He seems to, yes.
Like, dude, you really think this is a game, but it's not, bro. It's not a game.
Well, Cyrax, I would put myself in your perspective. If I was one being attacked, well, the most simplest thing I would do is just shut off the internet because everything... Everything that happens on
that's
here.
The thing, bro. I shouldn't have to do that, though, man. That's the thing. I shouldn't have to do that. That's
and
what
this
you
is how he wants to make his living as well. So, you know, you're cutting off the way that he wants to, you know, carve his career. It's unreasonable to ask him to shut it off.
Fair. But for real, Tyler, what I don't get, Tyler, is why is it that you're so hell-bent on having me off the internet? Like, what did I ever do to you that's so bad that makes you do this shit, that makes you want to come after me the way that you do?
Yeah, well, I wouldn't say that you've done anything bad to me.
Then why do it? Then why fucking do it? If I've not done anything to you, what's the point? What's the fucking point of it? Because it's not
my point. Hold on. Let me tell you my point. I like getting a reaction out of you. I like when you snarl your teeth, just like Marty's picture up there.
Yeah, well, guess what, Tyler? It seems to work. Yeah, well, guess what, Tyler? Those reactions are stopping now. And Marty, you're going to stop right now with the jokes. You, Schmeckle, Tyler are going to stop with these fucking crackpot jokes, stop with going after people, and stop going after my goddamn channel.
Well, if I don't shoot Cyrax, it's going to happen to me.
Yeah.
Well, Marty, if you had any fucking decency, if you had any shred of ounce of decency or respect in your body, you would stop this shit. You would set an example for Tyler. Like, I'll be straight up honest with you.
You set an example for your
Tyler, let me tell you, bro. Let me tell you something, man. Even though I can't stand your fucking ass,
you're not going to be
able to. Marty.
You won't be able to.
But here's the thing, though, Marty. I've been trying to be a good person. I've been trying to step away from the bullshit. I've been trying to step away from the fucking bullshit. But what y'all two knuckleheads keep on doing, keeps on dragging me back. And I don't want that. That is not what I want for myself. That's not what I want for Tange. That's not what I want for either of our families, bro. That's not what I'm about. All I want to do is be able to live my life doing what I enjoy outside of the bullshit, outside of the fucking drama. This isn't fucking funny, and it's not cool. It's
Cyrax. Well,
yeah, hi. We'll see who's laughing once you get your ass knocked the fuck out by somebody bigger than you, Tyler.
Cyrax, you're not bigger than me.
That's gonna happen.
Marty, I didn't say me, you fucking idiot. So shut the fuck up.
All right.
Tyler, you think that you're this badass dude, but really, you ain't shit.
You're damn right.
You're
I
not
really Cyrax. So compared to you, you know, I bully you because I know you won't be able to do anything back. But hypothetically. We're not really hypothetical. You are the bully, Cyrax.
How am I the bully, dude? I've only been defending myself against you guys.
Defending yourself?
What do you know? No.
How can you say that?
How can you sit there and say that I'm the bully when really you two are the fucking bully?
Well, Cyrax, because I was your friend.
Shut up for a minute, Marty. Marty, what you don't understand, you have a sick, twisted obsession with me that's not fucking cool. It's sickening, and it's disturbing as fuck.
That's okay?
It's wrong. It's nasty. Like, bro, me and Tonic caught you fucking... Dude, we caught you fucking fantasizing about me on Tonic.
Well, so what? Fuck you and fuck Tonic. Why would you even care about that situation? You are literally the bully. You steal people's artwork and music, but then yell at them how they stole your work. When in reality,
Tyler, that's the thing, though, bro.
What's the thing?
You think I do, but I really... I don't.
AJ Vega?
Yeah. Sarah, Marty, shut up for me, dude.
That's irrelevant, bro.
Shut up.
That's irrelevant, dude. What is relevant? What is relevant is you two fucking knuckleheads shutting the fuck up and leaving me and Tange the fuck alone before I come up there and bust a fucking hole in your goddamn skull.
What happened to Mr. Cyrax?
No, I'm fucking tired of this shit, dude. I don't deserve the shit you put me through, man. I don't deserve it. Tange doesn't deserve
it. I'm tired of it as well. Absolutely.
I don't deserve it, Marty. You need to quit. You need to quit. And Tyler, you need to grow the fuck up and quit with your bullshit. Because like I said, it might not be today. It might not be tomorrow. Hell, it might not even be a week, a month, or a year from now. But I promise you, dude, you keep running your fucking mouth. Somebody that's bigger and tougher than you is going to come along and fuck you up for the shit you're doing. You think you're untouchable, but you're not. You think that somebody's not going to do something? That's where you're wrong. I promise you.
Well, sorry, you're implying somebody's going to touch you.
Listen, bro. Somebody will eventually come along and fuck your ass up, and you're not going to do anything about it because nobody's going to be there to fucking save your ass.
Hold on, Cyrax. You know what? I've had enough of your bullshit. This was supposed to happen a long time ago, fuckboy. You know, Cyrax. This is it, man. The arthritis gloves are coming off. The leather jacket's coming off.
Tyler, you are such a fucking moron, dude.
Man, man, shut the fuck up, dude. Yo, Marty. Yo, Marty, throw on a beat really quick.
Oh, really? You really want to get destroyed and embarrassed?
Yeah, fuck yeah, dude. Throw on a beat.
You really want to destroy the fuck y'all two motherfuckers right in front of your whole fucking fan base? No, thanks, dude.
Right here and right now, Marty. Throw on that fucking beat, man.
Wow. Can you know what, Tange? Hey, Tange, what I'm going to do, I'm going to have you check your private messages. I'm going to send you my phone number so you can call me.
Yo!
What are you going to... I've sent you an email.
Okay. Wow, really? That's all you fucking got, bro. Come on. Like, that's dumb.
Very
Tyler. I'm
ready.
You know what, Tange? Why don't you knock the fuck out of here? I'll email you.
I think that's my cue to leave. You know, thank you for... letting me on. Thank you very much. Bye.
No problem. Tell your boyfriend to go fuck himself for me.
Yeah. Why?
Well, I guess this is just pretty much you can say anything, Tyler. This is going to close out the old show here. What an amazing turnaround. It's almost hard to even believe.
Well, he tried to change my perception of reality around. I don't think it worked.
Wait, hold on. I turn off for a minute.
Okay.
I appreciate that. Thank you.
Cyrax fled.
Can you maybe play one of your tracks or no?
There's not been one time where Cyrax actually sat down on the panel with me and had a rap battle. It's unfortunate, but at the same time, it's fortunate because he automatically gets disqualified.
It's true. When it came down to it, he just didn't have the temerity or the skill. Well played, Mr. Tyler.
Well, he does still have his channel, but he can't log into it.
Yeah, what good is a channel that you can't log into?
Yeah, exactly. You know what? I think the gods have praised us and let us know.
Did you see CC's video today?
Whose?
Canada's?
No.
Oh, my God.
You want to play Death Threats, bitch? Let's play Death Threats. Because I can play that game way better than you can. And unlike you, I can hold up my end.
Wait, hold on. Are you playing a video?
Yeah. Oh, shit. Sure, my bad.
It's fine. It's fine.
What? I can hold up my end.
He's so deranged.
So keep toying around, Marty. Yeah. What?
You are fucked.
Yeah, fucked. Oh, my goodness.
What?
You should shut the door and tone it down. You won't get up. Now it's up for the night.
Sorry.
Sorry.
I love Ed.
But like I said, Marty.
I can still hear you.
Keep on playing your fucking games, Marty.
Don't worry. I will.
Hey Tyler, instead of being a little bitch, why don't you bring your ass up here so I can stalk your face in, you fucking pussy.
Anywhere I would have followed you.
Oh man.
Say something, I'm giving up on you.
Oh.
And I'm feeling so sad. What's
wrong with my hair at this wheel? It's all dirty.
Nothing at all. And I will stumble and fall. I'm still learning to love. Just starting to crawl. Say something, I'm giving up on you.
Oh my God.
Sorry that I couldn't get to
you. So my first initial thoughts, you know, if I would have watched that without being on the panel, I would have thought Ed passed away. I really would have, and I would really be upset by that.
Yeah, he's a good man. He puts up with a lot.
Yeah, and that's why I really do respect him. And he's tougher than everybody watching his live stream combined. I mean, try living with Cyrax, 24 hours a day, all night, every week, every month. He's just screaming all night long, and he can't get a proper rest.
Yeah, you would lose your mind. Like it would be inevitable.
I wouldn't even stay there for $1 million.
Come on. No,
I wouldn't. You know, just too many bed bugs. We have to deal with Cyrax.
So. I cut him off.
Yeah, Jamie's dead.
Yeah, Charlie. Yeah, Kurt Cobain, he's always been a rabble rouser.
He really has. You know, I figured it was him. With the mask on.
Yeah.
I just couldn't figure out what his name was, but I'm sure that at this point I couldn't get the rap battle Cyrax again.
I mean, you beat him with the yowl. He knew that you had a level of energy that he couldn't.
Yeah, he was like, oh, wow, and he's fucking lived.
easiest musical defeat I've ever seen.
I'm gonna put a motherfucking scar on your face. Gonna call you Scarface.
Damn, kill them, crush them.
Yeah.
And now's as good time as any as ever.
Yeah. ARJ Cyrax is not gonna come back up here. It's not gonna happen.
No. It's been very emotionally charged. Tyler, thank you very much. If you have anything to do with that password, I mean, I would hold it over his head until he's willing to negotiate with us. Personally. Well,
I hope people keep an eye out for his new channel that's going to be coming up soon. He was using his Dark Star Films name, so maybe he's over that YouTube channel now. Not too sure about it, but...
Huh.
Well, this live stream definitely made history. We got Cyrax to stay calm on the panel.
Yeah, this scared straight speech really gave me something to think about. But then you realize,
and that isn't the first time I've heard that speech. I mean, I heard it on numerous live streams. I'm going to go to jail and maybe straighten my life out. And Cyrax says that he has more experience with life than I have. When Cyrax probably hasn't even left the house in a decade, you know. So
that's a good point. But when he did, it was really uncomfortable, agonizing.
Yeah. So yeah, this live stream, I really did enjoy it. You hit 100 viewers again, congratulations.
Well, thanks. Yeah, I don't you know, I appreciate everyone.
Yeah, but anything to overthrow Tonic.
True.
So great seeing everybody. Right after I get off of here, I'm gonna drop the song probably right away.
Fuck yeah, man. Beautiful.
Oh yeah, dude. So Marty, I'll catch you later.
All right, sir. Thank you very much.
Later. BSR for life, I guess.
BSR for
hopefully, I might not go to jail soon. So
this is definitely our year. So thank you, sir. Everyone, thank you for stopping by. Wow, that's all I can say is wow.
Yeah, but it feels so right. feel so right. I cuss like a knife. Yeah, but I feel so right. Yeah.
DeMarco.